It was a long time ago, when I was still a student, I had to provide an academic search, like a lot of people of my age. It was a huge search, like lasting around 6 months. And the longest part about all of this is not the writing, no. It's to decide what kind of sources you're gonna choose. And you know what? I didn't have the chance to know web scraping at that time, but you have. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to scrape results from Google search with Octoparse. If you didn't already download the tool, you can find the link in the description. My name is François and welcome to this new tutorial. The first step is to take your URL related to Google Scholar and to paste it on Octoparse. I'm gonna show you two scenarios. The first one is if you want to scrape only one keyword, and the second one is that if you want to scrape multiple keywords at the same time. So, the first scenario is really simple. You've got your search bar, you click on it, you click on enter text, and you enter your keyword. So let's say, for example, English literature. I click on confirm, and then I go to options, and I click this box, hit the return key when finish entering. Once I click on this box, I'm going to add a timeout, so let's say 3 seconds. I load the page with Ajax, but that time I add a higher timeout, let's say around 15 seconds. And what happens is that I've got my research. Because when I click enter, basically, I've got my research. That makes sense. Now the second scenario, if you want to scrape multiple keywords. To do so, I'm going to create a loop. I create my loop, and to enter multiple keywords, I select text list. And you can freely enter your keyword. Let's say data mining, big data, and web scraping. That's 3 keywords. That should be enough. That's 1 keyword per line. I click on confirm, I click on apply, and I've got my keyword. But as you can see, at this very moment, the current keyword is still English literature. It didn't change. To make the change, I drag the enter text inside the loop item. Then I'm gonna select the enter text once again, and I check this box, enter text in the loop to enter the text box. Once you check this box, let's make another test, loop item, enter loop item. Now the keyword is data mining, because I use the keyword I input inside the loop item. To scrape our data, we click on this yellow button, and we click on auto detect web page data. This will be really fast. Within a few seconds, we will scrape as much data as we could have. And here we go. We've got 10 lines, which is correct. And we've got 24 fields captured. Actually, 24 fields is a bit much. So I invite you to sort your field out. Let's check it out. I've got my title, which is good. My title URL, I keep it. This is the source and the author's name. So that's a good colon. I don't know what that colon is, but I probably don't need it. This one neither. I delete all the unnecessary columns.
A few moments later.
We're good now. I uncheck add a page scroll because I don't need to scroll the page down to have access to more results. And I keep the box paginate to scrape more pages, because we've got multiple pages. I click on create workflow. Your final workflow is over, but we have to change some settings. The first thing I wanna change, it's up to you, but I want to extract only 10 pages per search, per keyword. So I repeat the pagination 10 times. Another thing I wanna change, and it's not up to you, it's actually mandatory, is to add a waiting time. Google Scholar applies some anti-scraping techniques. So if we scrape the website too fast, we will have to pass a reCAPTCHA test. And I hate it, we all hate it, so let's be careful and add a waiting time. I wait, let's say, 3 seconds each time. We save our task and we click and run. We have the choice to run our task on our device if we are still with the free version of Octoparse, or we can run our task in the cloud. If you want to try the premium version of Octoparse out, you've got a 14 days free trial. Make your choice and run your task. As we have planned, we've got around 300 lines spread over 3 different keywords. We can export our data. And you are now ready for your academic search. I tell you good luck and see you next time. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.